Thank you very much indeed. And the final item of business this evening is a member's business debate on motion 8731 in the name of David Torrance on Race for Life celebrates 30-year anniversary. The debate will be concluded without any questions being put, but I'd invite members wishing to participate to press the request to speak buttons now or as soon as possible. And I invite David Torrance to open the debate around 7 minutes. Mr Torrance.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. It is my great pleasure to open the members' business debate this evening on Race for Life and to recognise the work of Cancer Research UK, thus to support our constituents. I'd like to thank my colleagues for supporting the motion, allowing this debate to go ahead. This widespread support is a testament to thousands of participants and volunteers who have been involved in Race for Life events across our country over the past 30 years and pays tribute to the huge success of this vitally important initiative. I'd also like to thank Emily and Sorsha from Cancer Research UK for taking time to travel to Parliament today for this debate, and can I welcome them to the Chambers. This debate gives us an opportunity to acknowledge the invaluable work undertaken by Race for Life and Cancer Research UK, and the staff, volunteers and participants who form the backbone of this initiative. The hard work that happens behind the scenes to organise and run these events is a great achievement. For 3 decades, Cancer Research UK Race for Life has provided an opportunity for our communities to raise money for life-saving cancer research. Their track record is seriously impressive. In 30 years, over 10 million participants have taken part in Race for Life events, raising over £940 million towards life-saving cancer research and supporting more than 130,000 cancer patients across the country with radiotherapy every year. All Race for Life sponsorship goes towards Cancer Research UK life-saving work, funding laboratories, tests and treatments for all 200 types of cancer. Thanks to significant investment and dedication in research, there have been notable improvements in early cancer diagnostic and treatment across Scotland. The initiative spearheaded by our government and delivered by exceptional NHS staff are making a difference in the lives of the very people we are here to represent. We have made significant progress in improving survival rates of cancer in recent years, thanks to the tireless work of researchers, medical professions, campaigners and thousands of fundraising efforts like Race for Life. We cannot forget the heart and soul of Race for Life, its participants. An astonishing 10 million individuals had donned their running shoes, sweatbands and pink ribbons to stand up against cancer. They come from all walks of life, all levels of fitness, all backgrounds and all genders, unified by a shared objective to improve cancer research and ultimately beat cancer. It is their collective spirit, their dedication and their selfless endeavour that we really are here to honour and celebrate today. Earlier this month, over 1,600 people took part in 2023 Race for Life in the Beveridge Park in Kirkcaldy, my constituency. We raised an inspiring sum of £92,000 for cancer research, and I was delighted to meet many of them and participate at the finish line to award them their medals. As anyone who has attended Race for Life events will know, the atmosphere is deeply moving as communities come together to celebrate the lives of these dear to them. From the moment I arrived, the park was awash with colour, from a sea of pink T-shirts to colourful wigs and even a dog in a tutu. Every single person was there for the same reason, to have fun and remember the lives and experiences of those they loved. It is easy to get swept away with the facts and figures. However, the reality of this terrible disease really hit home when I was speaking to participants about his stories and their motivation for signing up. Stories such as 11-year-old Sashisha O'Halloran from Fife, who was chosen as a VIP starter to sound the horn at the start of events in Kirkcaldy. Earlier this year, Sashisha was diagnosed with Hodgkin lymphoma, a cancer of white blood cells. She stood at the start line and cheered on the crowd, which included her mum, sister and brother. Also participating was Jonah Keddie. She was running in memory of her mum, Sheena, a nurse from Kirkcaldy Victoria Hospital, who died from breast cancer last year. Speaking after the race, she says, "I was thinking of my mum every step of the way today." And this was echoed time and time again as I spoke to people who shared their stories with me, with comments such as, "I know my dad would be proud of me right now." And today, I felt my best friend was still here, running beside me. And then there are those who have battled cancer themselves and won, who are running to show others that this crucial disease can be beaten. I was left in awe of their bravery and determination. I cannot express enough how proud I am of constituents who participate in these events, fundraise which help scientists find new ways to prevent, diagnose and treat cancer, help saving more lives. Each and every individual is a beacon of hope and a symbol of resistance against cancer. I would like also to acknowledge and thank Indigenous organisers and tireless volunteers who make these events possible. Cancer touches all of us at one point or another, be it personal experience or through our loved ones, neighbours or colleagues. The funds raised at Race for Life events have been and will continue to be instrumental in groundbreaking research, providing resources and tools necessary to continue our fight against cancer. The funding contributes a wide array of cancer services, including gloves which help scientists stay safe while in the lab, microscopes and equipment which is used to measure the size of tumours and learn how we grow, an invaluable cancer chart which helps thousands of people affected by cancer and going through very challenging times. This groundbreaking work, supported by events like Race for Life, is contributing to more people surviving cancer. We cannot underestimate the importance of ensuring that the voices and experience of people affected by cancer are at the heart of the policy. So many of our constituents are impacted by cancer, and it is crucial that they are at the centre of our approach going forward. Thousands of families in our communities have faced indescribable pain of losing loved ones to this dreadful disease. We owe it to them to strive for continuous improvements in our healthcare services, particularly in the field of cancer research. I am grateful at Scotland's commitment to investing in the Detect Cancer Early programme, with state-of-the-art diagnostic equipment is further enabling early detection. I also note the contribution of Transforming Cancer Care programme, a first of its kind in the UK, in partnership with Macmillan to improve the services offered by cancer patients. A significant breakthrough has been rolled out in rapid diagnostic centres across Scotland, including one in Victoria Hospital Kirkcaldy in my constituency. These centres aim to provide a diagnostic of all clear within 28 days of a referral, making the process faster and less anxiety-provoking for those involved. While we celebrate the achievements, we cannot afford to be complacent. We still face challenges. We need to tackle health inequalities that contribute to lower cancer survival rates in more deprived areas, and the road ahead is still long and filled with challenges. But optimism of Race for Life events is infectious, and I am firm in my belief in our collective ability to rise to the challenge. Scotland has a strong foundation to build on to improve cancer outcomes, and I am incredibly grateful for the brilliant work of Cancer Research UK to help Scotland continue to drive this progress. Presiding Officer, I conclude my contribution to this debate with a sense of pride and admiration as we honour and celebrate the 30th anniversary for Race for Life, an initiative which has touched the lives of thousands of people across Scotland. It is a pleasure to be able to formally acknowledge the incredible work done by Race for Life and by Cancer Research UK, and I would like to extend my heartfelt grateful to participants, volunteers and supporters of this wonderful initiative. I also extend my best wishes to everyone across Scotland taking part in the upcoming Race for Life events this year.
Thank you, Mr. Torrance. We now move to the open debate. I call first Craig Hoy, to be followed by Jackie Dunbar, around 4 minutes. Mr. Hoy.
Thank you, Deputy Presiding Officer. I would like to thank David Torrance for bringing forward this very important debate to recognise the 30th anniversary of Cancer Research UK's Race for Life. Every year, tens of thousands of Scots are diagnosed with cancer, a number which is only set to rise in the coming decades. Every one of us across this chamber and everyone across the country will have had their life touched by the impact of cancer. Today I think of my late friend and neighbour Sue in London. Sue died of cancer far too young. She left behind a family and friends and a void among us. Or my partner's father, Alf. Alf fell ill with a very difficult to treat cancer while visiting my partner Mark and myself when we lived in Asia. He then faced a grueling 16-hour flight back to Edinburgh, accompanied by a doctor and Mark's mum, Anne. And the weeks that followed were difficult for our family and for Anne and Alf's many friends, some of whom visited Alf in his last few days at home in Portobello. And as the family came to Alf's bedside, so too did a team from Marie Curie, who helped nurse Alf, providing support to Anne, Mark and his sister Louise. And it was then that I was struck by just how important those organisations, often charities, are, and the support that they give to those living with cancer, and of course to those families who are around them. Now, sadly, too many of us have only memories of a loved one who suffered from cancer. But thankfully, many more have the comfort of family or friends who have survived cancer and who have come through the treatment and are now living healthy and normal lives. And they do so thanks to the huge efforts of a wide range of charities, clinicians clinicians and, of course, our NHS. And that is why it is hugely important that we in this Parliament recognise those efforts, and particularly today, Cancer Research UK. 30 years ago, Cancer Research UK established Race for Life, a series of fundraising events right across the UK, which are open to everyone. People of all skill levels, all ages, all walks of life, all can come together to celebrate the efforts, the collective efforts to combat cancer and to promote healthy living and wellness too. And the Race for Life is all about celebrating life and those who face or who have faced cancer. Runners are encouraged to wear bright clothing and race at their own speed to raise funds for life-saving cancer research. And the race has raised over £940 million towards cancer research in the UK over its three decades in operation. And this year there will be events in Edinburgh, Glasgow, Aberdeen, Dundee, Fife, Falkirk, Stirling and in Inverness to help fight cancer. And it's vitally important that we in this Parliament do our bit to raise the profile of initiatives such as this. So I would strongly encourage my constituents and anyone interested to donate or to take part in the event in future years. And somebody said to me today, would I be doing it? And I think I can commit now to doing it. I may be walking it, but I can commit to doing it. Because Race for Life has helped Cancer Research UK fund over £33 million worth of cancer research in Scotland last year. And that money has supported laboratories and institutions in Glasgow and Edinburgh, and hundreds of scientists, doctors and nurses across Scotland. The race has offered a critical lifeline for cancer researchers and patients right across Scotland. And that is why I would like to say thank you and express the thanks of my constituents to all of those who have participated and supported Race for Life over the last 30 years. Each and every one of us who has lost someone to cancer has a good reason to want this commitment to be redoubled and for further progress to be made in combating cancer. And we hope that that continues for another 30 years to come. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you, Mr. Hoy. That commitment is now on the parliamentary record. I now call Jackie Dunbar to be followed by Carol Mochener in 4 minutes. Ms. Dunbar.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And can I begin by thanking my friend and colleague, David Torrance, for securing this member's debate this evening. And can I also take this opportunity to thank Cancer Research UK for all their hard work that they have done and continue to do so on a daily basis. Presiding Officer, David Torrance spoke about pink wigs in his opening speech. And I kind of laughed and I apologise because I know it's a serious subject. But it brought to mind the day that Kevin Stewart MSP and I, when we were both councillors, decided to don pink curly wigs and walk the floors of Marshall College rattling our tins, trying, it's before your time, Douglas Lumsden, you'll be okay, to get money for cancer research. I still have those photographs, Presiding Officer, so if anybody wants to make donations to cancer research, I am gladly will show them them. Presiding Officer, cancer affects... I'll
You've goaded him into it.
Do I give my time back, Presiding Officer?
You will get the time back and more. Douglas Lumsden.
Thank Jackie Dunbar for taking that intervention. I was just going to ask Jackie Dunbar if she'll commit to doing the race like Craig here, and I'll maybe even put £50 into the pot.
Ooh.
Jackie Dunbar.
I've already done it, but absolutely I will, and I'm going to come on to the Aberdeen one as well. Presiding Officer, cancer affects us all in some shape or form, and it touches all of us at some time or another. It's a cruel disease that we would all like to banish to the history books. One day at a time, one step at a time, we will beat cancer. We just have to. Race for Life is celebrating its 30th year and has been a huge success. It started as a women's only event in Battersea in 1994, where 750 participants raised £48,000. Since then, it has grown into a series of hundreds of events, with more than 10 million folk having taken part in that time, raising over £940 million, as we've heard, which helps fund research into more than 200 types of cancer. In 2019, for the first time, the Race for Life opened its doors to men to participate too. So if Douglas Lumsden wants to join me, he's more than welcome to. making it truly a truly inclusive event, giving folk the chance to come together with their family and friends and join the movement to help beat cancer. Many moons ago, I was one of the 10 million folk who have taken part. I took part in the Aberdeen Race for Life when they were being held at Hazelhead Park, which shows you just how long ago that was, as it's now being held down at the beach in Aberdeen. My daughter Dawn and I took part for a number of reasons. Dawn was keen to take part to celebrate her auntie, Frances Walker, who was a warrior at kicking breast cancer right in the end. And Frances also, I'm delighted to say, is still a cancer-free warrior, living life to the full, enjoying spending time with her grandchildren. And while wanting to celebrate Frances, I also wanted to do it in memory of my mum, who Dawn never got to meet. My mum died at the very young age of 34 to ovarian cancer. And I still wish to this day that Dawn was able to meet her grandma Barr, but cancer just didn't allow it. Presiding Officer, this year's Aberdeen event will take place in July the 2nd, and I've just heard that I'm doing it, at 10 a.m. meeting at the King's Links Beach Esplanade. Even if folk can't manage to take part themselves, they can still go down and support those that can. Although I will say it is never too late to register and take part. For everyone who takes part, sponsors, raises money or whatever it is they do to help beat this vile and awful disease, I sincerely say thank you. From the bottom of my heart, thank you.
Thank you, Ms Dunbar, and I hope you and Mr Lumsden enjoy your Race for Life together. And I now call Carol Mochan for around 4 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And can I thank David Torrens for bringing this debate to the Chamber, allowing us to again talk about the very important issue of changing the outcomes from cancer.
Ms Mochan, could I just ask you to turn your microphone in towards you a bit?
Oh, sorry. Sorry. In this chamber, it is right that we do use much of our members' debate time discussing cancer, cancer treatment and the research needed to ensure we fight and beat this devastating disease. When you say out loud the figures of cancer diagnosis, we know why as parliamentarians we spend so much time discussing, debating and analysing treatment paths. There were 35,379 new cancers registered in Scotland in 2021. That is an increase of 5.5% compared with 2019. And it is in line with a long-term trend of increasing number of cancer diagnoses over time. The most important thing when thinking of these numbers is to think of the person and families behind those numbers. Every number is a person who will be unsure of what is ahead of them in the days, weeks and months ahead. We know cancer can affect people physically, emotionally and financially, and it has a huge emotional challenge for family and friends as well. I think this is why volunteering and participating in communal events is so appealing for people. And so while fundraising, one gets the opportunity to participate in a group event, space to share experiences, stories, and perhaps find some common ground. The lovely thing about Race for Life is that all fitness levels are encouraged to do what they can to contribute to this common goal of raising money towards cancer research. We need research into cancer now more than ever. Research has changed the goalposts and tipped the dial in the correct direction. Over the last 40 years, cancer survival rates in the UK have doubled. In the 1970s, just one in four people survived their disease for 10 years or more. Today, two in four survive. Cancer Research UK has a clear goal and want to accelerate progress and see three in four patients surviving the disease by 2034. We are, of course, lucky to have excellent research facilities in our education departments, and I understand Cancer Research UK leads research in areas such as cancer biology, cancer drugs, cancer trials, early diagnosis, immunotherapy, new technologies, personalised medication, prevention and radiotherapy. However, it would be wrong not to take this opportunity to note that Cancer Research UK did make a decision to end core funding at the Beats in the west of Scotland, which is one of the largest clinical trial units in Scotland. We do need to continue investing in those areas, so it is important, I think, that we recognise that Scotland can hold these trials and it is welcome when research funding is placed in Scotland. Presiding Officer, the last point I wish to raise, and it's one that I have repeatedly raised, is the inequalities in prevention care and access to cancer care treatments. For many of the most marginalised in our society, their chances of getting cancer and their experiences and outcome of cancer are worse because of factors and circumstances beyond their control. Key to reducing cancers and cancer inequalities is acknowledging and dealing with the root causes which blight many of our communities. Across Scotland, we know that the most deprived populations have worse experiences and outcomes than least deprived areas. In Scotland, we must act with purpose to reverse these concerns. Early detection gives those who have cancer the best chance of life. We must use events such as Race for Life not only to raise awareness of the disease and to focus on the importance of research, but also as a reminder of the long way we have to go in addressing health inequalities. I do really appreciate all the contributions this evening in the Chamber, and I wish everyone taking part in Race for Life the very best. Thank you, Presiding Officer.
Thank you very much, Ms Mochen. I now invite Jenny Minto to respond to the debate. Minister, around 7 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. And I'd also like to give my heartfelt thanks to my colleague David Torrance for bringing this motion to the Chamber today and allowing us all to recognise the value of Race for Life. I'd also like to welcome and thank you very much for all the work that you do to Emily and Sorcha, and it's great that you've been able to join us here in our Scottish Parliament. And also to all my colleagues for sharing such valuable contributions to the debate. As Craig Hoy said, this is our opportunity, and in fact, I think it's more than an opportunity, I think it's our purpose to raise awareness of cancer, so thank you for highlighting that. And as Carol Mochen said, every number is a person, and certainly in my role, I have, as Minister for Public Health and Women's Health, I have found the personal stories and meeting people really, really important. So I appreciate David Torrance's talking about Sheena's daughter and the quote, "I felt my dad would be proud of me doing this." I can reflect personally on that and imagining that my best friend is running beside me. And then Craig Hoy talking about the void. I think that's a really poignant way of describing losses. And Jackie Dunbar celebrating Francis the Warrior, but also in memory of your dear mum. So I thank you very much for sharing these stories with us. I've also reflected very much on the role that charities play with regards to cancer, and part of the team, part of that intersecting team to help researchers, clinicians and the NHS all working together, and also with communities, and I think that is really, really important. So I'm very delighted to mark the 30th anniversary of Race for Life this year. The level of participation and commitment shown by all those who join the many events across Scotland and the rest of the UK is so impressive. Many participants consider Race for Life as a way to share their own or their friends' or family members' experiences of cancer, as we've heard. And congratulations to every participant in raising the funds to support research. You are making such a difference to the lives of people with cancer right now and in the future. As others have said, Race for Life is an inclusive event. Everyone can participate, no matter their fitness level. I know they have varying lengths of races, and some are muddy obstacle courses for adults and children. So I'd love to see Jackie perhaps doing that with your pink wig on as well. I might even join you. And as David Torrance said, a recent event in his constituency earlier in May. And also, as Cancer UK's website says, you can sign up as a volunteer if running's not your thing. And this just brings a whole new energy, smile and passion to the party. And let's help beat cancer. So if you're not running, then you can volunteer as well. I am aware how truly important Race for Life is to Cancer Research UK, with it being their biggest series of fundraising events, having raised, as others have said, over £940 million. Seriously impressive. I want to take some time to recognise the importance of cancer research's role in funding vital and life-saving research into all types of cancer. Here in Scotland, Cancer Research UK currently work in partnership with the universities of Edinburgh, Glasgow and Strathclyde, and Lothian and Greater Glasgow and Clyde NHS boards. Their research work focuses on a number of cancers, including those that unfortunately have poorer outcomes, such as brain, pancreatic and liver cancers. The Scottish Government is clear that research is essential if we are to continue to develop new and effective approaches to the diagnosis and treatment of cancer. In partnership with Cancer Research UK, we have increased funding for the experimental cancer medicine centres in Glasgow and Edinburgh. These specialise in the delivery of early phase cancer clinical trials. The combined Scottish Government and Cancer Research UK funding for the adult and children ECMCs is £4.68 million over 5 years from the start of this current financial year. As the Minister for Public Health, I must highlight the importance of preventing cancer, and I know this is an area that Cancer Research UK is also particularly keen to address. We recognise the importance of public health initiatives in reducing the risk of ill health, including cancer, to everyone in Scotland. And that's why we introduced the minimum unit pricing in May 2018 as one of the actions within our alcohol framework 2018 to tackle alcohol-related harm. We also want everyone in Scotland to eat well and have a healthy weight to help reduce the impact of a range of diet-related ill health conditions. Raising awareness of cancer through taking part in Race for Life is particularly appropriate given how important physical activity is for our general health. Being physically active is also one of the most important steps people of all ages can take for cancer prevention, treatment and control. Where these preventative measures have not had anticipated outcomes, we know that the risk of cancer can increase. Cancer remains a national priority for the Scottish Government and across NHS Scotland. We are developing an ambitious 10-year cancer strategy to launch very shortly. The strategy will take a comprehensive approach to improving patient pathways from prevention and diagnosis through to treatment and post-treatment care. Its visions and aims will be supported by a 3-year action plan. Work to develop a new earlier cancer diagnosis vision in Scotland that will outline the future of this programme is nearing completion and will form part of the new cancer strategy. The programme helps ensure that those with suspected symptoms of cancer are put on the right pathway at the right time. Our aim is to reduce later stage disease so that cancer, when detected, is more likely to be curable. Presiding Officer, in closing, I would like to thank those that support Race for Life and the ongoing work of Cancer Research UK in funding life-saving research and in awareness raising. And for anyone wishing to join this year's Race for Life events, you can find out more on their website, raceforlife.cancerresearchuk.org. I want to reiterate to members and those watching the debate of the Scottish Government's enduring commitment to reduce the burden of cancer in Scotland through a wide range of actions, from prevention and early intervention, through to strengthening treatment options and providing broader supportive care. As Jackie Dunbar said, one step at a time, one day at a time. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Minister. That concludes the debate, and I close this meeting of Parliament.